More details tonight in the shooting at the Independence Mall Saturday.
This is police continue to look for two persons of interest. KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney has the latest.
Indeed, two people continue to be recovering from minor wounds that they got during that shooting late on Saturday afternoon. Also, some more stories about those hectic moments continue to emerge, and the search continues. Police continue to circulate these photographs of potential suspects, but there's been no video released of what happened on the lower level near the Sears store.
It was just more, you know, kind of like that, and he just, his arm was wiggling, it looked like. You know, we were running, and it was scary, and it didn't look like he was really aiming at one thing and, you know, just started shooting.
Several people we talked to spoke of a frightened crowd charging the doors to escape.
The fear on their faces. And that little guys, little kids, and they're shoving them around.
I saw one woman who was in a stroller, or was pushing a stroller, and she was pushing with one hand and ducking over her head and over the stroller to protect her child and was just running.
Police continued to try and string the story together. There was talk of an argument between a couple of groups on the lower level, and then a fight, and then shots. Many say they heard three. Etheridge heard more than that.
I thought I heard five. I know the first one, it was the loudest. It was the loudest because we were the closest, and then it was about four, maybe five total. I mean, the echoes in the mall, it was loud, but about four or five.
Some people thought it was safer being outside. This woman wasn't so sure.
Just, you know, saying, okay, everybody can go. I just kind of felt that once we found out that they didn't have anybody in custody, you know, they were sending us out to be targets.
And a spokeswoman for the mall says if anybody thinks that they lost or dropped something in those hectic moments as people were scrambling away from the shooting scene, they could be possibly found at the guest services desk here at the mall. That is on the 39th Street level, which happens to be the entrance to the mall that's right over my shoulder right here. That's the latest from here. Back to you.
Micheal, thank you. Again, police are looking for two persons of interest in connection with the shooting. If you have any information, call the TIPS hotline, 816-474-TIPS.